Hello, welcome back to my channel. My name is Ifa Labi, and thank you so much for coming back to my channel. Now, this particular video I'm going to do has been one that I wanted to do since last year. No, in fact, since the beginning of the year. I've been talking about it on my social media. I've been doing so many things that, oh, I have to do this video. I think I've done like draft of this video that I never put out. Now, I decided to do this video because, look, we need to talk about this TV show. We need to talk about the fact that it's been going off the rails for a long time. And you know how like there are so many shows that is bad, but like it's so bad is good. This show went from it's so bad is good to it's so bad. What is happening? It feels like the writers, they picked like 5-year-olds and 80-year-olds, and they pick like 15-year-olds, and they were like, give us your best advice, like give us the best storyline, go da. And they put it all together and write, and like, you know what, this makes so much sense. Because sometimes when I watch it, I wonder how like a room full of writers like come up with these storylines sometimes. And if you don't know the show I'm talking about, it's Riverdale. Now look, I'm a huge fan of teen shows because I feel like, I don't know, there's nowhere in life where you see 25-year-old cosplay as 15, 16, 17-year-old high school people. It gives me so much joy to just watch it. Ever since Gossip Girl, I've been a huge fan of watching like teen shows, Pretty Little Liars, Vampire Diaries, you know, all these teen shows. They've been very entertaining for me. Riverdale is just, I don't know. I like, you see, this is my thing. When Riverdale started, I was like, oh, that's such a cute show. And for me, it was very similar to Pretty Little Liars because, you know, in the first episode, someone had died. So it was like, oh, it's a murder mystery. Oh, it's really cool. Then they solved the mystery. Then in this two, there was someone that was a vengeance killer. There was the Black Hood. In season two, I was going off rules, but I still stuck with it because I'm like, I like where this is going. I mean, it's off. I'll still follow it. Season 3, that was the Gargoyle King. And I was like, wait, what's happening to this show? I think when I stopped watching was season 3, episode 13. When I got to season 3, episode 13, I'm like, you know what? I'm not going to do this to myself anymore. I think I called my sister. I called my little sister. I'm like, look, Irabna, I'm not doing this anymore. And I'm not the only one. I feel people are still watching it because they feel like they've followed the show so far. So they're going to see it to the end. Now, to show you how much, like, I decided that, let me just write for, like, you know, reasons. Let me write why I stopped watching Riverdale. And I came up with, like, so many reasons why I stopped watching Riverdale. Now, as with most shows, the first season tends to be, either the first season tends to be your best season, or the first season tends to be, like, you know, the warm-up. And for Riverdale, the first season was, like, the best season, in my opinion. You might think I'm wrong. Even if you think I'm wrong, let me know in the comment section below. And you have to tell me why I'm wrong about season one being the best season. And for the reasons why I stopped watching Riverdale, oh my God, it's just diverse. It's just various reasons. And the number one thing for me was a storyline. I didn't understand where the storyline was going. When I stopped watching, there was a cult. And then there was a nun. And there was a drug called Jingle Jangle. And then the parents that are supposed to be parents act more like teenagers. And the teenagers, it was just all over the place. So at a point, I was so confused. And I don't like when I'm confused about a show. Like, for me, it's different when, like, a show is just bad. Like, it's just bad storyline from beginning to end. So I just be like, no, I won't watch it. Or I don't like the direction of the show. And then I won't watch it because I feel like the show and me, we don't gel. I don't watch it. Like, I watch the first couple of episodes, I'd be like, this thing isn't for me. Like Bluff City Law, and true enough, it's going to be canceled. So you see, you know, I'll be like, okay, no, this isn't for me. Then I'll stop watching it. I always give shows a chance. I'll watch the first couple of episodes. If I don't like it, I'll log off. But for Riverdale, it was just off. Like, everything about it was just a mess. First of all, Riverdale has a very weird aesthetic, right? The show is set in 2019, but it has a very 50s feel to it. Like, a lot of the things about the show has a very old golden era feel to it. It feels like it was set in the 50s, but it's like 50s transplanted to 2019. So let's see how that works out. It's obvious, and like the diners they go to, like, it feels very, if you've seen the second part of The Kingsman, yeah, where the woman has a secret lair and everything, that's how it feels like. It feels old school and modern at the same time. And that tone was just off. I mean, you can appreciate it, but at the same time, like, is this 2019 or this is the 1950s? You know, so I mean, that I have no problem. Like, that's not like a major gripe. So I don't care. I mean, I watch it anyways. But the sex scenes, like, there used to be like all these weird ass sex scenes all over the place that made no sense. Archie and Veronica, those people are like the most inappropriate couple ever. Like, every something is happening. Oh, Archie, my dad, da-da-da-da. And the next time they're having sex. I'm like, wait, what's happening? Catch me up to this. Like, at every point in time, like, for any point, at any point, Archie and Veronica must be having sex. Anything. Archie, I can't believe you did this to me. And I was like, what is happening with these characters? It was so exhausting. Betty will be a sheriff, a bad bitch at some point, and at some point she's the good person, and she wear a wig, and she has an alter ego, then she's an undercover cop, and then Jughead. So you see, the tone is all over the place. Betty and Jughead, are they like solving murders? You know, the part that just was weird for me was when Archie went to prison for some strange reason, and then whilst he was in prison, Veronica and the rest of the cheerleaders did a cheer routine outside the prison walls. I don't know where that happens. Apparently only in Riverdale does your boyfriend is in prison and you go and call your squad and they'll come and do a cheer dance to cheer up your boyfriend in prison because you think it's your dad that sent him to prison. No, that was just, I saw that and I was like, what's happening? Another reason is that, see, Riverdale is, like, the fashion in Riverdale is so weird that the cheerleaders even have shada for a funeral. One of their cheermates got murdered and these people pulled up in black cheer costumes. I was amazed when they had the funeral and then they were all wearing black cheer costumes. I was like, oh, so this is the thing. So people die so much that they even have a costume for funerals. That's what's up. I mean, that is really what's up, because look, no other television show will give you all this drama and still be terrible like Riverdale. And the one thing that just blew my mind was the fact that Veronica owns a speakeasy. Now, if you don't know what a speakeasy is, you know, I have to go to Wikipedia. A speakeasy is an illicit establishment that sells alcoholic beverages. And it came into prominence during the Prohibition era. Now, according to the show, they're teenagers at 16, 17. How in God's name, or how in heaven's name, does a 16, 17-year-old own a speakeasy? It's illegal, because in America, you can't start drinking till you're 21, not even 18. So how in God's name did a 16, 17-year-old own a speakeasy and is selling alcohol? If they say, well, she's not selling alcohol, fine. They have, like, really weird things happening in Riverdale. In their first season, Betty does a stripper dance to be accepted into her boyfriend's gang, but they're not really a gang, but they all have gang, I don't know what it is. And I mean you can say that, well, teenagers do a lot of weird things a la Euphoria, but it's just, you know, that's not how they painted the show. They painted the show as, you know, this teen drama about someone dying, they're trying to solve the murder, and then it went into the supernatural. So I'm confused, is this more like Pretty Little Liars solving murder, or like Sabrina the Teenage Witch? Because I know it's a shared universe, so is it more like Sabrina or Pretty Little Liars? And that's where it all falls apart. Earlier this year, Luke Perry, who plays Archie's father, he passed away, and a lot of people were wondering, like, we're looking forward to see what Riverdale would actually do as a tribute. So because the season was already underway, they didn't touch his death till season 4 began, and they had a very beautiful episode dedicated to him, because truth be told, he was like the only sane parent on the show, and he passed away in real life. So that was really sad. So they found like a really cool way to like write him off the show, because he also died in the show, and that episode was really good. Like, it's really, I mean, in Riverdale terms, that was a really good piece of television, and they sent him away really well. And it was like the writer decided that we have to do this for Luke Perry, and then went off the rails again. So season 4 started very beautifully, and the rest of the season has just been, look, I have so many problems with Riverdale, and it's not just the fact that it's all over the place, it's everything about the show, because I feel like Riverdale had the potential to be like the next big thing, and then it became weird, and then it became awful, and then the parents just add to it, and sometimes I want to feel like the actors are in on the joke, like they know how terrible it is, so they are in on it. And I've seen a couple of their interviews where everybody asks them, like, are you guys aware that your show is crazy? And they sort of do this laugh about it, and like, no, you need to talk about it, because it feels like little children are writing the script week after week. But then I don't know, I feel like they are in on it, but we are not in on the joke. And if you're not in on the joke, I feel very offended, because that's what you plan seven to us is really weird. And this is the thing, because of streaming and because of Netflix, because Riverdale goes on Netflix, it has a lot of international appeal. So I'm sure even if CW wants to cancel it, Netflix is going to be like, no, a lot of international people are watching it, so you know, keep it on. So yet here we will be still watching Riverdale and still being offended. So look, Riverdale is a weird show. No matter which way you look it, cook it, cut it, it's a weird show. But let me know, do you still enjoy watching Riverdale? Do you still like Riverdale? Do you feel like we are being too hard on the show and that we should take the show as it is because we knew what we signed up for? Or you're also of the school of thought that they need to revamp the show and make it stick to a theme or not? So let me know what you think about Riverdale. Do you like Riverdale? Have you stopped watching Riverdale? Like, have you just given up like me? You've just given up and you're like, you know what? I'm not doing this anymore. So you stop watching Riverdale. Or you are persevering until the good night. You're like, you know what? It's terrible, but I'm still going to watch it. So leave me your comments below. Let me know what you think about Riverdale so far. 4 seasons of Riverdale. Let me know what you think. Recommend shows for me. You know, I'm going to open this. Recommend shows for me to watch. What show have you seen that I haven't spoken about that you feel like I need to talk about the show because the show bangs? Okay, let me know in the comments below. Thank you so much for subscribing to my channel. My name is Ifa Labi, and I will see you on my next video. Mwah.